guys, welcome back. Okay, so today the palette I'm playing in is this Elf and JKISSA to the Rescue palette. Very, very cute doggy themed palette. Now, mine will look different than yours or anyone else's because they do include a cute little sticker sheet that you can use to customize your palette. It is doggy themed because JKISSA loves pets, dogs, and it's themed around pet rescue. Now, this is what the palette looks like inside. Very, very pretty, bright, vivid rainbow colors. It is vegan and cruelty-free, of course. There are 12 mattes and 6 shimmers, and the net weight is 0.52 ounces or 15 grams. Now, let's go ahead and do some swatches. I'm not swatching the whole palette. I'm just going to swatch the top row of mattes and the bottom row of shimmers, just to give you an idea of how these shadows will swatch on my skin tone. As you can see, although the mattes are nicely pigmented, they are a bit powdery, so just keep that in mind. They're a bit powdery, but they do have some nice pigment. Now with the shimmer shadows, I would say these are really, really pretty. I didn't really care for the orange shimmer for some reason. I don't know, it just doesn't look orange. Maybe it's because it's on my skin tone. I didn't use it today, but the other shimmers, in my opinion, are absolutely gorgeous. Really, really pretty. So let's go ahead and get started. Now for my look today, I'm starting out with my brows, of course, going in with some of my e.l.f. lock-on liner and brow pomade. Just using a thin brush to apply that pomade to my brows. And I'm just going to use the spoolie end of this brush to kind of brush out the beginning portion of my brows so that they're not so blocky and choppy. Now to clean up around my brows as usual, going in with my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer just to kind of, you know, make my brows look a little bit neater and not so rough. Now, once I have that done, I'm going in with a new eyeshadow primer today. This is my Pretty Vulgar eyeshadow primer, my first time using it. This is what it looks like. It's fairly thick and it comes out of the tube looking white, but as you can see, when you apply it to your lid and kind of blend it out, it does sheer out and just kind of creates a nice base for your lid, but it is not an opaque white base. So if you're looking for something that's like white or bright, this is not the primer for you. So this is what the palette looks like before the stickers. Like I told you in the beginning, this is the sticker sheet that they supply with the palette so that you can customize it to your own personality. And I really like it. I do have a Rottweiler myself. So let's go ahead and get started with this first shade. It's the shade Paloma. And I would really describe it myself as kind of like a mustard yellow. It's a very, very pretty color. Very pretty. But as you can see, it definitely takes some building up. I'm just using a fluffy brush, applying that to the upper portion of my lid because this is the color that I want to blend my crease color into. You can definitely build this yellow up to your liking. If you use more of a tapping motion, you'll probably get more opacity, but this is pretty much how I wanted mine to look. Now I'm going in with this green shade. It's the lighter green color called Peaky. And as you can see, that pigment shows up. When you place your brush down, it shows up. But as soon as you start to blend or try to blend, it kind of fades out a bit. And you can get a little bit of patchiness with this shadow. Now, what I do like about it is the fact that it is nicely pigmented, because even though it can get a bit patchy, you are able to build it up to where you can fill those patchy spots in. Now, what I will say is that in order to get the green and the yellow to mix the way that I wanted them to blend, it took me, I would say, a good 30 minutes just to get the green built up to the color I wanted it built up to, as well as for it to blend into that yellow nicely. So if you have a good 30 minutes, you know, to do your eye look, then you might be okay. Or you might just want to do something a little more simple, maybe a one color eye look. But in creating a look like this, where I really wanted that green to stand out and blend nicely into that yellow, it did take quite a bit of time, and it did take quite a bit of elbow grease of going back and forth into the palette. But you can see it's building up. Now I'm just taking a bit of that yellow, blending it on the edge of that green, just to make sure those two colors are seamless and there's no harsh lines. Now I'm going into this gorgeous blue shade called Thatcher. And the names of these shadows are actually names of rescue pets, rescue dogs, I believe. So each name does have meaning. So just wanted to let you guys know that. But I'm tapping that blue in the corner, noticing that, yes, there is a little bit of patchiness. So I'm just trying to stick to the tapping motion to get the pigment down, and then gently blending the edge into that green so that I don't lose any of that color. As you can see, this shadow is very, very pretty, but you definitely have to take your time with these. Now going back into that green and just gently blending it into that blue, making sure that everything is nice and seamless before I move on to my lid. Now, as you can see, the outer corner of this look is a little bit messy, so I am going to go in with a wipe and just kind of clean up those edges and make it a little bit more sharp before I start on my lid. So for the lid, the first shimmer I'm going into is this green, which is called Reagan. Spraying my brush with a little bit of, I believe that was my Mario Badescu spray. And I'm just using a flat shader brush and applying that to the first half of my lid. And like I said in the beginning, the shimmers are gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. I don't have any complaints about the shimmers that I used. And I used 3 of the shimmers today. So I would say it's a really, really nice formula for e.l.f. Next, I'm going into the blue, which is Bailey. Taking another flat brush and wetting it and just tapping that right next to that green. I want those to kind of blend into each other and just making sure the outer corner is nicely covered with that shimmer as well. Now to make this eye look more cohesive, I went back into that blue matte shade, taking a pointed fluffy brush, and I'm just tapping that in that corner, blending it into that blue shimmer, just so that is a really, really nice blend in that corner. Now, even though I did spray my brush before I used the shimmers, I did get a bit of fallout. So I found that I did have like glitter particles on my face. So I'm just removing those before I move on with my liner. Now for liner today, I'm going in with one of these gorgeous NYX Vivid Brights liners. This one is the shade Vivid Sapphire. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous blue. If you love color and you like to kind of add different dimensions to your eye looks, try out some of these eyeliners because they can really, you know, amp up an eye look or just add a different aspect of color when you're creating. I love this color blue, and I think it really went well next to the green and the yellow. Now for my lower lash line, I'm going in with another colored eyeliner, but this is a pencil liner, and it's one of the LA Girls Shockwave Neon liners, and this one is in the shade Gotcha. I love these pencils as well. Now going back into the palette, I'm taking the lighter blue shade, which is Cannoli, and I'm just taking a flat brush and tapping that on my lower lash line. Now, although this blue looked a lot lighter in the palette, it actually looks a lot closer to the color of my eyeliner. It showed up darker on my lower lash line than I thought it would, but it's still very, very pretty. And I think it went well with that blue eyeliner. So this is what we have so far. Now for my inner corner, I'm going into this beautiful yellow shimmer called Firefly. And I'm just taking a pencil type brush, spraying it once again, and just tapping that on the inner corner. Nothing major, just a little tap tap. And this is what that shimmer looks like. I really like it. I think it was very nicely pigmented, went on easily. I didn't have any issues applying it, and it's really, really pretty. Now for lashes, I'm popping on some of these Beauty Creations lashes that my girl Lily sent me. These are some of their 3D silk lashes, and they're in the style Overcommitted. I really like the fluffiness of these lashes. I think they're really pretty. And for my lower lash line, I'm actually going in with the Maybelline Lash Discovery Mini Brush Mascara. Lining my lips with my ColourPop BFF4 lip liner, and I'm trying out one of these Beach Cosmetics Cashmere Cream Lipstick. I love the color of it. It feels nice, but the applicator is horrible. The applicator is basically just like a stick, and so it makes applying the lipstick just like it would be easier to just use my finger. So I like the color of it, like the feel of it, but the applicator is trash. Okay, so for setting my look today, using my Wet n Wild Matte Finish Setting Spray. Love this stuff, you guys. It's one of my favorite drugstore setting sprays. And this is the final look. So yeah, I went bold today, you guys. Very, very bright blue and green eye look. I'm rocking my earrings from DJ's Unique Boutique. Check out the description box so you can see what other goodies she has in store for you to buy. But that's it for today, you guys. Thanks so much for hanging out, and I will see you on the next one. Toodles!